This is 5 variable Carnot map, and we have 2 4 variable map Carnot map to form the 5 variable Carnot map, because the number of input is 5, so the possible combinations are 2 power 5, which is equal to 32. Okay, so we have M0 to M31. Okay, 16 cells here, 16 cells here. And this entire block, okay, will represent A bar, and this entire map will represent A. And we have BC along the row and DE along the column for both the maps. And the min terms here, it is exactly the 4 variable Carnot map, and then we start from M16, M17, M18 and then M19. Similarly, M20, M21, M22 and M23. Then we skip one row because we are following the gray code sequence, and we are making sure that these two rows are adjacent to each other. And M24 will appear here, M25, M26 and M27. And then we have M28, M29, M30 and M31. Totally 32 min terms. And these yellow cells, okay, 16 cells together will represent B bar, and this light blue block will represent B. And already we have seen that the entire, this 16 cells together will represent A bar, and this 16 cells will represent A. And we can wrap it vertically and horizontally. Here we have wrapped both the maps horizontally, and these 16 blocks, okay, all yellow blocks are adjacent to each other, and we can group them all together, and the block that we get is C bar. Why C bar? When you consider the row, since the block is across these two maps, A will not appear, because A is A bar here, here it is A. So A will not appear. And when you consider the row, we have 0, 0 and 1, 0. Both are B is varying. B is taking the value 0 here, B is taking 1 here. So B will not appear. C is the same for these two blocks, so its value is 0, so it is C bar. And the block appears across all the 4 columns, so DE will be varying here, so the block is only C bar. And why this is adjacent to this one? When we fold it, because only it is varying by A, otherwise the values of BC and DE are same. And when you consider these 16 blocks, they all blue shades, we get the variable to be C, or the product term is C. And the adjacency of these two maps, so you can imagine, like, you can put this map over this one, okay. We can overlap the map of A bar with map of A, and this will be adjacent to this one, this column, okay. All these cells will be adjacent to this one, and this cells are adjacent to these cells, okay. So we can, it is just like overlapping, and these are adjacent to these columns. And hence row wise and column wise, both are adjacent to each other. Okay, similarly, these are adjacent to these ones, and it has to be overlapped. Is this column, okay, this column, okay, this column, is this adjacent to this one? That is a question, right? So how do you know whether this column is adjacent to this one? What is this value? We have 0, 0, 1, 0, right? This is 0, 0, 1, 0. And what is this one? 0, 0, 0, 0. And how many bit changes you have? You have 0, 0, 1, 0. That is this cell. Okay, this cell is 0, 0, 1, 0. And this cell is all zeros. Okay, we have 4 zeros. So, how many bits are the same? We have 3 bits to be same, okay, and the only one bit is varying, so it is adjacent to each other. And similarly here it is 0110. What is here? 0100. The change is only in this bit. Okay, so these column is adjacent to this one as well, this column is adjacent to this one as well. Okay, similarly the rows, okay, when you wrap it horizontally, all these things will be adjacent to these things, these are adjacent to these things, and so on. So this adjacency, when you have a doubt, you can just write the terms and verify that it is varying by only one bit. And when the number of variables is more, finding the adjacency of these cells and using the Carnot map becomes difficult. And we have one more alternative to Carnot map, which is also systematic, to compute the Boolean expression in a simplified way. Grouping all the yellow cells together, okay, we get D bar, and all the blue cells we can group together because they are adjacent to each other, and we will get the term D, which you can compute. Similarly, we can group all the corner columns and we can get the block. Okay, we have 16 cells in this yellow block, and that block is E bar. And all the blue cells we can group together as a single block, and we get the expression E. Now let's consider an example for a 5 variable Carnot map. And we are to simplify this Boolean expression, okay, and sum of min terms, that is what is listed. So we have marked the ones, okay, so it is 0 means M0, okay, and M2, M5 is this one, M7, M8, M8 is this one, and M10, 1010, it is here, and so on. Okay, so we have marked it, and the patterns of 1 comes like this, and we know that these 4 cells are adjacent to each other, and these 4 cells are adjacent to each other, and when we overlap the block of A bar with A, these 4 cells will be adjacent to these 4 cells. So I can group all these 8 cells together and form a single block. And what is that block value will be? Here along the row we have B is varying, C remains the same, and it takes the value 1. So we will get C in the product term. A will not appear. Why? Because the block is across these two blocks. Okay, and A value was 0 here, it is 1 here. So A will not appear. And along the column, if you see, we have D is varying, E remains the same, and the value of E is 1, so E will appear as 1. So this yellow block take the value CE. Similarly, we can group all these violet ones, and we have already seen that these cells are adjacent to each other. Okay, so we can form a bigger block of 8 cells together. And how do we write this one? A is varying because the block is across these two maps, and along the row we have 0 0 and 1 0. So C bar is appearing, and then along the column we have 0 0 and 1 0, so E bar is appearing. So C bar, E bar appear in the final simplified expression, and we have sum of products.